Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Basic or Service Now Learning. So in today's video we are going to explore knowledge management in ServiceNow. So let's see what all we are going to explore today. In this session we will be having an end-to-end demonstration of knowledge management in ServiceNow instance. We will talk about knowledge management, knowledge base, knowledge management process, roles and responsibilities, overview of knowledge workflows, known error database, and table used in knowledge management. So let's begin. So let's first navigate to ServiceNow Personal Developer instance so that we can have a little understanding of the application. So friends, this is my ServiceNow Personal Developer instance. So in application navigator, type knowledge. See, when we type knowledge, so we have, see, under self-service, we have module called knowledge, and we also have a knowledge application below where we have lots of modules under this knowledge application. Okay. So the knowledge which is available in self-service is basically for users, means those who have to see the knowledge articles, those who have to get the information from the knowledge articles, means all the users must be having access of this knowledge module which is under self-service. But this application knowledge is only available to users, those who are working on knowledge articles, means knowledge support staff, or for the contributors, or for the authors, those who help in creating knowledge articles, or for those reviewers, approvers, subject matter expert, etc., means whose contribution is required for knowledge articles. The access of knowledge application will be granted to those members only, and this the above rest this knowledge will be available for all the users under self-service. So let's talk about this knowledge first. Let's open this knowledge in a new tab. So see, this is basically a UI which is available to all the users or all the staff members, through where they can find knowledge articles, they can search for knowledge articles, even they can read the knowledge articles from here. Here we have a create an article button. As I have logged in through system administrator, so I must be having all the rights. So because of that, I am having an access of create an article button. But in some cases, in some of the organization, this button is only available for the users, those who have a right to create a knowledge article. So before we start with all the other stuff, let's first understand it, what is the knowledge management and knowledge base, so that we can relate that what exactly the knowledge base is, okay, and why for knowledge management is used in an organization. So let's first see what is knowledge management. So friends, knowledge management is a continuous process to understand organization's knowledge needs. We can say that it is a central repository which holds the article and accessible to all the users. The primary goal of knowledge management is to drive meaningful, useful information within the organization. Okay. Now, as I have seen here in the UI that we have knowledge bases. Let's see what is the knowledge base. So knowledge bases is basically used for categorization of information. Let's say we have some information related to IT, we have some information related to hardwares, let's say we have some information related to HR policies. Okay, so we can categorize information in different sections. So we can say that we can create a knowledge base of HR where we have all the documentation regarding HR. We can say we can create a knowledge base name as IT, where we will keep a documentation regarding IT, or we can say we can create a knowledge base as a hardware, where we will keep all the documentation regarding hardware, right? So in this way, knowledge base is basically a categorization of particular information. It can be derived from ServiceNow operations, it can be derived from incident and problem change processes, it can be derived from process and policies, it can be derived from risk mitigations of change management application, or there are lots of other areas from where we can derive knowledge bases. Okay, so as in the application we have a knowledge base, right? So it means we have three knowledge bases: IT, knowledge and social QA. In this application, basically these three knowledge bases are provided by ServiceNow out of the box. We can also create other knowledge bases, right? So this is out of the box, so that's why we have only three knowledge bases available over here. Now here we have the content. most viewed, most useful, featured content. So most view is basically like 5 or 10 articles which are mostly viewed by the users. These are most useful, basically those articles which are mostly useful for the users, where the user has given the feedback that this is useful, this article is basically useful for them. So let's say 10 articles will be displayed over here which are featured. Okay, so in case if somebody want to see the articles which are available in IT, then he can click on a knowledge base and he will get all the articles which are available in IT, even though he can also navigate it through the category, because in knowledge bases we are also categorizing the same. Okay, so IT having a different categories like application, Microsoft, devices, email, IT, operating system, suppliers, etc. So same as knowledge bases must be having a lots of categories as well. So in this way, as I have said in the knowledge management definition, that knowledge management is a central repository which holds the article and accessible to all the users. So it means it is a central repository which holds the articles which are accessible to all the users. Okay, so I think now the definition of knowledge management and the understanding of knowledge base is clear to you, right? So now let's move to other topic, that is why this knowledge management is required in an organization. Okay, from where we can get the input, means from where we can get the information, and what is basically the outcome of that information, right? So let's navigate to slide. So the input sources can be any, right? It can be internal sources, it can be external sources. Internal sources like from HR policies, HR documentations, hardware documentation, software documentation, any knowledge from the server end, any knowledge from any life cycle or from any phases, from service operations, transitions, processes, etc. Right? From external sources such as like vendors, if organization want publish any information into ServiceNow instances which is related to vendors, then they can also publish, then they can also treat that information as an input resources, right? Then what happened after all these internal or external sources, as far as the knowledge process, this data, this information is manipulated, reviewed, verified, validated, and after that the outcome is structured information, organized information, authenticated information, verified information, the information which is relevant, usable and purposeful for the user has been published into ServiceNow instance, into ServiceNow management application. Okay, so the input source can be any internal and external, but the outcome is very much useful for the end users, for the staff users, those who are accessing the particular articles. So as we are talking about like knowledge management process, so let's see what exactly the knowledge management process is implemented into ServiceNow, and we will also do a practical implementation in ServiceNow so that we can understand the process. So the knowledge management process is, so here I have created a slide where we have some blocks, some arrows, right? So the first is draft, then it is going for submit for review, then it is going for validation, then if approved, then it is going from some other validations, okay? And then it is published. So to understand this, what I will do, I will navigate to ServiceNow instance here, and I'll navigate to this knowledge application. Okay, so as I have said, in this knowledge applications we have lot of modules like create new, import articles, published, retired, all, and lots of other modules as well. Okay, first see that from where we can create our knowledge articles. So this create new and this import article, basically two modules which are used to create knowledge articles. So when I click on create new, see, we have a form with lots of fields: knowledge base, valid to, short description, article body. Okay, so from here we can also create a knowledge article. So knowledge article is basically created by author or a contributor, means who want that particular information will be in ServiceNow instance. So he will create this knowledge article, he will fill the information and submit it for review. Okay, so as I have told you that knowledge base is basically used for categorization. Let's say we have some knowledge bases IT knowledge, so I am selecting IT over here. Then, as I have displayed earlier, that IT is having a lots of categories in it. So he can create a category accordingly, that what kind of information it is and where he want to categorize it, he can select accordingly. Then here we have a valid to date. Valid to date means whatever information author want to publish or author wants that will be available for user, there must be some expiry date. Okay, I'm not talking about medicine, I'm talking about article, because medicine is always having expiry date. So same as in service now, article is also having expiry date. Let's say we are giving a solution article to a particular user, but that solution will be available for only 5 months or 6 months. So it means it must be having some expiry date. So each and every article is having an expiry date. So if user want, he can change the date from here. Otherwise, as far as the code execution is going on the back end, it is calculated as 112100. So if this article which I am going to create right now will get expire automatically on this date. So there is two things. If the article get expired, it means the or retired. I'm talking about expired, basically the term is retired. I'm sorry for that. So if I'm saying that the article got retired, it means it will not be available to end users. And the article will only available to end user when the article got published. So see here, the workflow status is draft. Okay. So as I have said in the sheet, the first status is draft. So at the status of draft, a contributor and author will create a knowledge article. Let's say I'll fill some short description. Demonstration. And to explain this short description article, I want to show you some article here. Let's say Microsoft Outlook issues. So this is basically a short description which I have given over here. And This is basically an article body. So what I'll do, I'll copy the stuff from here and I'll paste over here, because it's pretty difficult for me to write data again and again. Okay. So in this way, I can create whatever the content I want. This is basically a text editor where I can write the data. I can give some font styles, font sizes. I can bold or make it italic or something. Okay. So I can manipulate accordingly that what all I want to display as a header, what all I want to display as a in a small letter or something, right? So in this way, a contributor and author creates an article. So once he creates the article, what he will do? He will submit it for review. Okay, so let's save it first. So see, once I save this article, we have a buttons available over here, that is publish, retire, update, search for duplicates and delete. So as we know that ServiceNow applications are customizable, right? So this is basically out of the box application. So that's why we have a button called publish over here. But some of the organization having a button such as submit for review. So once the author click on submit for review, then this workflow status changes to review. Okay. But here we have a button publish, which is functioning same as the submit for review button. Okay. So here when user click on or author click on a publish button, so the article got changed. It means I have the article in list view. Okay, go from here. So we have this article 15. Open this article. See, this is the article which we have created. Okay, the content, the short description. See, the author clicked on that publish button. Now the workflow moved to review. Means it is submitted for the review. Okay, so once the article is submitted for review, then the approver will receive a notification that this article is submitted and he have to review and have to move forward. So he validate and verify submitted article from a technical perspective, and if he approve, then the particular article moves to a next level. Or if he reject the article, then the author or the contributor receive an email that this is rejected by the approver or the subject matter expert. So you have to again see the content or modify the content, whatever the feedback has been provided by the approver or the subject matter expert. Okay, so let's assume that this article has been approved. Okay, so let's navigate to ServiceNow application and approve the article. See here in the related list, we have a section called approval. Okay, so this article is sent for a review to Bernard Loboy. So Loboy can approve or reject the article. So I am a system administrator, so I can do on the behalf of Bernard Loboy. So what I will do, I'll open this. See, I have two buttons, approve and reject. I'll give any comments. And after giving the comment, he can approve it. So once he approved it, see, workflow changed to publish. Okay, so once he approved it, then workflow changed to publish. Okay, so see, we have another section available over here, that is ensure language correctness, written in consistent manner and suitable for target audience. So in some of the organization, we have a specific team that after the approval, what they will do, they will ensure the language correctness, that the language is in a consistent manner or not, or the language or the word are technical as per as the suitable target audience or not. Basically, this work is done by technical writers, that they see the content again and then they click on a publish button. So that depends on organization to organization, whether directly approved to publish, or if they want, they can add one middle layer into it which also verify the content and then publish the article. So in this out of the box ServiceNow instance, when the reviewer or the approver approves the article, then it directly moves to a publish status. So the workflow changes to publish. Okay, after the article got published, then it is available to the end user. Let's see where. So just navigate to this or navigate to here, from here. From the user perspective, on a self-service, click on knowledge. Once we click on knowledge, then we have created that article under IT knowledge base, right? I am clicking on that. See, I click on that. See, this is the article which I have created. Short description, knowledge management demonstration. When I click on this, see. So in this way, article has been created into ServiceNow instance, where the author first create the article and submit it for review. After the approver, review the article, validate the article, and everything is validated, the language and all, then that article will be published by the approval of the approver. Okay, and see, now user have access of that article and he can read the data and work accordingly, even though he is also having access to give a feedback from here, that whether this article is useful for him or not, or he can also leave the comment, even though he can also provide a rating, star rating from here. Okay, so in this way, user can also provide his feedback to the articles. Here he is also having some buttons like flag article, create incident and edit. So this edit button is basically available to user, those who have access to create a knowledge articles, to edit the knowledge articles. But for the rest of the user, this button is not available. Okay, so let's move to this article number, that is here, KB00100015. See, we have a valid to date. So this date comes into picture after the knowledge article get published. So let's move to our workflow, or we can say knowledge management process. So once the article got published, then the two things can be happen to article. The article can be retired or article can be renewed. So as I said earlier, that after the date which is given over here, after this date, the article will not be available to user. Okay, and this article will get retired. But knowledge article gets scanned or reviewed periodically. If article is required after the given requirement date, then it will get renewed and the requirement date will get extended to another date. Then what will happen? So if the subject matter expert realizes or thinks that this article need to be available to the end users other than this date also, then what he will do, he will change the date to some other date so that it will be available to users. Okay, so in this way he can renew the article. Renew the article is basically that increasing the valid to date. That is basically a renewing the article. So as we have discussed the knowledge management process, let's see what are roles and responsibilities. So in ServiceNow, there are lots of roles and responsibilities in knowledge management application. The first role is contributor and the author. This is an important role where the contributor or author can be the all support staff. That matters that this access has been given to all the staff that they can contribute from there. So there can also another scenario from where the user can create an article. I told you earlier, right? That is import article. See here. So from here also, User can create an article. So what happened? Let's say I don't have access access of a knowledge management application, but I want to contribute in knowledge management. I want to publish some article over there. So what I will do, I will create a Word document of that, and I will provide that Word document to a specific team that this is the content which I want, that it should be in knowledge management in ServiceNow, because it will be useful for user. Okay, so what they will do, they will browse that file, Word file from here, select a knowledge base and categorize it and import it. Once you click on import, then automatic knowledge article will get created. So in this way also, a user can create a knowledge article. Even though if someone wants, not from that scenario which I have given earlier, like example, if someone wants, he can create a Word file and then he can upload the work file here and create a knowledge article. Okay, so in these two ways, from the knowledge management modules, user can create a knowledge articles. So as mentioned in roles and responsibilities, contributor or author can be the all support staff. Contributor identifies content, that what is missing and what can be incorporated into the knowledge base. Contributor provides suitably written articles, right? Then after the contributor and author provided a suitable written articles, what the another role is? Another role is SME or approver. The SME approver, or we can say technical SME, or we can say builder, verifies the content of the article for technical accuracy. They approve it for publication or reject the same if not suitable, and he can also verify the content on periodic basis. The another role which I have said, the section that was in blue, some of the organization applies that phase after the approval, that is technical writer phase, where a technical writer will ensure the content written in the consistent manner, language correctness, suitable for a target audience or not. After they think that everything is fine, they modify the data accordingly and they click on a publish button and make it available for the end user. The most important role is knowledge manager. So knowledge manager is the owner of the process, and he is responsible that what all fields will be available in knowledge form, what would be the required process for different knowledge bases. He is the whole sole owner of knowledge management. He will take care that what exactly the workflow will be available for what kind of a knowledge base. Let's say IT having a workflow where we have approval, but knowledge is a knowledge base where we don't have an approver. Means if the knowledge article is created for a knowledge base, then of a knowledge category, then there is no approval required. The article will get auto-published, because probably it can be possible that the author is a subject matter expert who is getting that article. Then the most important role is user. So here, users or consumer is the all support or staff members, like all the members who are working in an organization, or all support or all staff members who use provided content for the requirement, and also they can also help to improve content quality by giving feedbacks. So as I have displayed earlier, that users having a section where they can provide a feedback, they can provide a star rating, right? Or there where they can provide a comment. So in that way, they can also improve the content quality. Let's say user reads some article, he found the data is not correct, or the language is not correct, or there can be some more steps, so he can provide the comments over there, and those comments, those feedback will be incorporated as per as the process. Okay, so these are the basically roles and responsibilities. So now let's talk about workflows in ServiceNow, where all the workflows are attached. Okay, and what is the use of the workflows and what exactly the workflow is. So now let's navigate to ServiceNow application and type knowledge base over here. So this is basically from the development perspective. Okay, so see, in knowledge we have a module called knowledge bases. Click on this. So if ServiceNow administrator or ServiceNow developer wants to create a knowledge base, so he can create a knowledge base from here. This is a table called KB underscore knowledge underscore base. Click on new button and you can create a knowledge base as per as the requirement. So I'm opening two knowledge bases, that is IT and knowledge. This is the out of the box knowledge base provided by ServiceNow. So here, see, this is a knowledge base IT. So see, here we have an option called publish workflow and retire workflow. Means here we can attach a workflow, whatever workflow we have created. So if you want to know that how we can create a workflow, I have already created the video for the same. You can refer that video and come to know that how we can create a workflow in ServiceNow. Okay, So this is the workflow which is named as knowledge approval publish, and for retiring the workflow, retire workflow is knowledge approval retire. Okay, and this another knowledge base having a different workflow, that is knowledge instant publish, knowledge instant retire, means this workflow does not require any approval, I believe. And this workflow we have already run that, so requires the approval of a Barnard lawyers, right? So in this way we can create our own workflow, we can create our own phases as per as the organization requirement, and we can attach those workflows in the knowledge bases, and then knowledge management process will work as per as the attached workflow only, right? So this is basically for the basic understanding, I believe, that is that from where we can attach the workflows in knowledge management. Okay, now let's talk about table used in knowledge management. So there are lots of tables which are used in knowledge management, but here I have listed only four tables, the main tables which we use mostly, like KB underscore knowledge, where all the records of knowledge management will get saved, whatever articles created got saved into KB underscore knowledge, then whatever knowledge bases has been created will get saved into KB underscore knowledge underscore base, and whatever category, let's see here, see every knowledge base have a category, see here, from here we can create a category for a knowledge base. So whatever category we are creating over here will get saved into this KB underscore category table, and whatever feedback is given by the users or the consumers will get saved into KB underscore feedbacks. So these are the most important four tables which we use in knowledge management or knowledge management process. So there is one more thing which I want to discuss, that is known error database. So as I have told you that there are only two ways, right, here to create a knowledge article. Just a second. The two ways are create new and import article. But I want to say that there is one more way to create a knowledge article automatically. That is known error database. So basically a knowledge article has been created through problem management process. So known error database is a basically a repository of those articles which is created through problem management process. So let's say if any problem ticket is closed with a workaround, then knowledge article gets auto created from it and will be having an information that has been provided to close the problem ticket through any given workaround. So for an example, let's say lots of user is having a problem that a particular pop-up is getting occur in front of him. Okay, so what the problem, then what happened, the problem ticket has been created for the same, then the team analyzed the same and they found a workaround that we can apply a notification closure for them. Okay, so they provided the step in a problem ticket and close the problem ticket with a workaround given the steps, by giving the steps, and what will happen, a knowledge article will get auto created from that problem ticket with the article body of the content given for that workaround, the steps, right? So what happened, that particular article will be available to all the users. So if the user will face that problem, what they will do, they will go and open the knowledge article and read those steps, and by itself they can solve that particular problem. Okay, so it will save the time. They will not call support staff again and again, ki we are having a pop-up problem, please rectify it, please resolve it. So what they will do, they will navigate to a knowledge management application, open the articles and see what exactly the steps are, and resolve the problem by himself only. Okay, so friends, I believe now you have an understanding that what is a knowledge error database, what is knowledge management process, what is knowledge management, and we have also seen that how we can run end-to-end cycle of a knowledge management application, right? And how we can publish the articles, how that article will be available to end users, how he can access those articles, right? How can they can provide the feedback on the articles, how can they flag the articles. For flagging the article, what they have to do, they have to only click the flag articles, see, give the reason and submit. In this way they can flag the article. Okay, so this is the whole soul process of knowledge management application in ServiceNow. So the UI which we are seeing over here is kind of a UI which we are used from the past few years, but now in ServiceNow we are also having a ServiceNow knowledge portal. So I will be giving a demonstration of that particular UI and how we can modify that particular UI in my next session. So friends, this is all for this video. I hope this video will be helpful for you. So if you have not subscribed the channel, then please do subscribe the channel. Please do not forget to subscribe, and please like, share and provide your comment below, because your like, share and comment give me a motivation to post more and more videos of ServiceNow. Thank you friends. Have a nice day. Bye bye. Take care and stay motivated. Bye.